But the steam engines down below here, Natchez steam engine, folks, these engines are 50 years older than the Natchez. They're 94 years old. These old steam engines came off of another steamboat named the Clarity that was owned by the U.S. Steel Company. We bought the old steamboat Clarity back in 1974 when the Natchez was being built. We brought it to New Orleans to the shipyard. We transferred those old engines off the Clarity and they're now on board the Natchez here. These old steam engines, they're horizontal piston-driven engines. They're high-pressure, low-pressure, reciprocating engines with 15 and 30-inch cylinders with a 7-foot stroke on the pistons. 2,000 horsepower to turn that big red and white paddle wheel back there on the stern of the Natchez. Folks, that big paddle wheel back there weighs 33 tons, built out of white oak and steel. That big paddle wheel is the only means of propulsion through the water. There's no propellers, no props on the Natchez, folks. Just the paddle wheel out there. 100% pushes the Natchez through the Mississippi. Now underneath the paddle wheel, there's three big 17-foot rudders. The rudders also came off the steamer Clarity. They're 94 years old. The engines and the rudders are the two oldest things on the Natchez. They come off the steamboat Clarity. Those big 17-foot rudders is what steers the Natchez up and down the Mississippi. Now, if you look up on the rooftop of the Natchez, in front of the Natchez powerhouse, you see those two big black smokestacks up there. These smokestacks are real. They're hooked up down here on the main deck. The two large Cleaverbrook boilers, 800 horsepower. They're fire tube boilers. We burn diesel fuel in them. Number two diesel. That's what heats up the water in the boilers and makes the steam for those engines. Diesel fuel. 200 pounds per square inch, going back to those steam engines, and turn that big 33-ton paddle wheel, 200 pounds of steam pressure. Back in the old days, we used to burn coal and wood in the boilers, but today we burn diesel fuel. That's one of the reasons you don't see any smoke coming out those stacks up there. Diesel fuel is very clean. If we'd be burning coal right now, you'd see a lot of black smoke up there coming out those stacks. The Natchez was built downriver to the right, folks, 30 miles down below Algiers Point. She was completed in 1975, World Shipyard had been, in Braithwaite, Louisiana, Bergeron Machine Shop. She cost $5 million to build. She's all steel, three decks. She's 265 feet long, 46 feet wide. The draft on the Natchez is only 5 feet. She's flat bottom, folks. That's all we need, 5 feet of water to float the Natchez. The Natchez is 1,384 gross tons. We are inspected by the U.S. Coast Guard. We're certified to carry on board the Natchez 1,233 passengers and crew. So sometime during careers, we want to invite you down to the main deck to come see the steam engine room. It's open to the public. See it for yourself. Now, if you look up on the front of the Natchez up forward, the mast, the big blue flag, got 50 white stars on it. This is the Maritime Union Jack flag. You'll see this flag flying almost all U.S. Navy ships around the world. The 50 stars is for the 50 states. The Union Jack flag on the front of the Natchez. Also, those two gangplanks out on the bow there, these are real gangplanks. We have a permanent gangway that's built on our dock here that's used for boarding and disembarking the passengers. When we take the Natchez to a different dock or out of town to a different city, we use those two gangplanks out on the bow there. These are real gangplanks. Be safety announcements while you're aboard the Natchez, please watch your step when you're walking about the boat. Please use the handrails when you're walking up and down the stairways. Please do not lean over the handrail. Do not sit on the handrails. Do not stand at any of the chairs or on the benches. We also ask the parents and the chaperone for smaller